to change the size of a series, so for example we have something like this where you can see one is thicker than the other, one way of doing it is making use of a secondary axis. So just to explain why, if I decide I want to change, for example, the size of the orange, I can right click, I say format data series. If I change the gap width, which allows me to change the size, you'll notice that if I change the one, so I make it very big, it actually changes both of them. But if we tell it, so I'm going to right click on this one, format data series, and I tell it it belongs to the secondary axis, you'll see at the moment it's overlapped. But now anything on the secondary axis is treated differently size-wise to the primary axis. So if I now go to the gap width, and maybe I'll make it a bit smaller, a bit bigger, you'll see that what it does is it now changes this series so that it fits within the primary series. So that's one way to do it, and you can play with that. The only problem you're going to have with this is that the series, the axes adapt themselves. So ideally you actually want both to be of the same axes, but in this case, because the orange is a lot smaller, the secondary axis is much smaller. So we might have to use another trick where what we do is we create hidden series to force the scales to be the same. In order to do this, you'll see I've created two new series, and just to make it easy for me, I've called it primary and secondary. What I have here is I've done a simple formula just to say, give me the smallest number you can see between those two. Over here, I said, give me the biggest number you can see out of all of them. And the secondary axes, I've just linked them, just said equals that, so that it's quite clear that they're exactly the same. Now what I can do, take these two series, copy them, and just paste them in here. So at the moment it looks like a bit of a mess, but that's because at the moment we can still see these axes. So let's just right click on any one of them and say change series chart type. And now we can see the budget is a clustered column, it's on the primary axis. The actual, also a clustered column, it's on the secondary axis. The primary, I'm actually going to make it a line chart. Same with the secondary, a line chart. And the reason that works is because the lines don't connect, so it actually, you cannot see it at all. Primary should be on the primary axis. I'm just going to switch that off. Secondary should be on the secondary axis. When I say OK, it looks like that. So now what we've got is the scale stays the same, no matter what happens, because if a number appears here, let's make that 250. Because of these hidden series, both scales always get to the same numbers and they fit in here, but you cannot see them. So this way you can now change, I can right click here and maybe the gap width a lot bigger to make that one a lot smaller.